When a Beatle brought in a project, it was generally with the intention of sticking with it. When George brought in Jackie Lomax, he intended to stay involved, to produce the record, to see it through. If your life's not right, doesn't satisfy you, you don't get the breaks like some of us do. Jackie Lomax was terrific, and George did a fantastic job, and you know, he did what a producer's supposed to do, you know, put a good band together, get the best out of the artist, and they are another record I think Apple can be proud of, despite the relative lack of commercial success. Apple Records were involved in the release of the Beatles records to the extent the Beatles wanted them to be, but as a practical, contractual business issue, they were still on EMI Records in the UK, which meant they came out via Capitol Records in the US, but all with Apple labels stuck on them. But certainly, from my point of view as head of A&R, I had nothing to do with those records. They were making those records just the way they always made them. The Beatles had met Billy Preston before, and had also heard him play with Ray Charles, and he was invited by George, I think, to play on the Let It Be sessions. And everyone's affection for him and admiration for his musicianship and his songs grew to him getting a deal with Apple Records. Why can't we be humble, like the good Lord said? He promised to exalt us, but low is the way. How men be so greedy when there's so much left? All things God given, and they all have been blessed. That's the way. Apple Records was an adventure at the time, and it obviously continues to exist to this day. When the history of music of the last century is written, Apple will feature in there quite prominently. Sonny, if you